DML and SOQL best practices. Because the, you can also use ID to merge rather than just the S object. If you've got the ID, you do not need the S object to merge it. You can use ID. Write down. Okay, let's talk about the first best practice. Exceeding the total number of allowed SQL queries. Right? Not exceeding. Let's write it down. Not exceeding the total number of allowed SQL queries. So we generally write down the program like this, where we want to get the opportunity records associated with a with an account, right? So what I'm asking for you to for you to do is get 5 accounts, and based on those 5 accounts, you need to get opportunity records related to them, right? So there is one query that you'll write down, in which you'll get all the accounts and all the accounts in that list, and for each account you'll write down another SQL query. So if there are 5 accounts, your total SQL query account is, if there are 5 accounts that you're getting as a result, then your total SQL query count in that program is, it's 6, because the one that you used for, to get the account records is already there. So if there are 10, 11, if there are 20, if there are 200, that exceeds the governor limits. So you should never ever write down an SQL query inside a loop. That's exactly what we have done over here. We've written down an SQL query or a SQL query over here. Select name from opportunity where account ID is equals to a.id, right? So this is a query which is written inside a for loop. This is not correct. This is not appropriate. What should we do? Okay. So what you need to do is you need to take the help of the in keyword that you understood. Let's have a look. Over here, what I'm doing is where account ID is equals to a.id. Again, for every account, I'm doing this. So that's the reason the queries, the count of the queries are getting increased. Let me show you what is the appropriate way. List account AC list. Select ID, comma name from account where created date is equals to this week. I've already got the account list. It's the same as of this one. And then what I'm doing is select name from opportunity where account ID in ACC list. So I've got all the opportunities in here. And this query is not written inside a loop. That's what it is. Is it clear, everyone? So never ever write down an SQL query inside a for loop or inside any loop, right? And use the take the help of in keyword to eliminate that thing. To eliminate exceed the query counts, right? Merging is used basically for reparenting from account to account one. Don't you think it causes loss of information from account two? I definitely think so, and it happens. But we still want, I've never come up across a situation in which I personally use merge, but it is given. So I have to explain it. Can you please tell me again how to count the SQL numbers? I mean, it's simple. So if your loop is getting executed for 20 times, then in that case, this single statement counts as one SQL query. This single statement counts as two SQL query. In this complete program that I have highlighted, there are two SQL queries. That's how you have to count the SQL query numbers. Make sense? Perfect. Okay, done. Write down this program, guys. What is not appropriate and what is appropriate? Also increasing. It also, obviously. So that's the reason, right? I mean, governor limits help, enforce you to create a program which is less complex. Because at the end, the resources are utilized of Salesforce. And they want the utilization should be optimum. And that's the reason these governor limits are placed, right? So we want you to use only the water which you require, not just waste it like that. So that's the reason we place a limitation over there. Next, exceeding the allowed number of DML statements. Okay. So similar to SQL queries, there are DML statements. There are governor limits on DML statements as well. You do not need to write down a DML statement inside a loop. Never ever. Over here, what I've done is, for integer I is equal to 100, I want to insert 100 account records. So what I'm doing is creating 100 account S objects in here and then inserting them all inside this loop itself, like this. This is not the appropriate way. What is the appropriate way? Create a list and then add it into the list and then use the insert DML statement onto the list instead of the particular S object, right? So not appropriate and this is appropriate. Write it down. Over here, what is the count of like DML statements in this program? What is the count of DML statements? 100. And over here, 1. That's how you reduce the count, right? That's how you make it optimized. Done, everyone? Cool. So that's all about DML statements, right? Let me just have a look once again. That's pretty much it about DML statements. Now, DML statements is done.